everyone, and welcome back to my channel. This is Erica from Confessions of a Homeschooler. If you're new, thank you so much for joining me today. If you're a returning viewer, I also want to thank you as well. You guys are the best subscribers in the world. Everybody's always so kind and courteous, and so just thank you so much for watching my channel. So for today, I have a really fun sewing video for you. If you follow me on Instagram at all, you'll see that I made this really fun bag. This is actually, I'm recently kind of taken up knitting, and so this bag actually houses my current knitting project, and I'm working on this sock, and so it's just really fun, and I wanted something to be able to carry my sock in, you know, if I go, you know, sit at swimming with the kids or whatever, and I just wanted a fun little bag. So anyways, I made up this bag, and I have filmed a video tutorial for you, and when I posted on Instagram, I called it the squishy bag, and a friend of mine said, oh, I want to get a pattern for the squishy bag, where is that? And I kind of laughed because I didn't mean to title it the squishy bag, but it is really soft and squishy. It's also super convenient and fun. You can really hold just about anything you want in this bag. It is a boxed bottom bag, and they're super easy to make. I want to say it takes me about an hour to an hour and a half to make one of these, depending on how fancy you get. And as you can see, I kind of got on a roll and I made several of them. This was probably one of my favorites just because I love this material. This is fig tree. But you can use, this is just a mini charm pack, and I pieced it together. You can also just do two kind of colors. You could also just do one color all the way around. This is completely customizable. This one I just kind of had some scraps of fabric, and so I just cut them about the same size and kind of pieced them together. And then this is the one that I'm going to show you how to make today. So anyways, this tutorial is super easy. It's very beginner friendly. I think that as long as you can sew a straight line and cut a relatively straight line, you can do this project. The only tricky part is installing the zipper, and quite honestly, zippers are actually really easy to install, and hopefully this video will help you maybe get away from if you have fears of installing zippers. So this is a really easy, fun project, and so if you want to see how to make these squishy bags, please make sure to keep watching and we'll get started. So I will also make sure to put the dimensions for this project in the description box below, and if I have time, I'll put it up on a PDF that you can download. If I do that, I'll put a link below as well. I'm trying to get this pattern up because I've had a lot of requests for it, so I may or may not have time for that, but the dimensions are super easy, so I'll make sure to at least have them in the text below. And then I'll have a link to my blog post with all the directions and supplies and all of that as well below. Okay, so let's talk about what you're going to need for this project. So you're going to need some fabric for the outside of your bag and some fabric for the lining. You're going to need some batting, and you're going to need a zipper. You're also going to need some fabric for your handle. And then I also like to use these are Clover Wonder Clips, and I really love these because we're going to be kind of pinning together some fat layers here, and these work really well. If you don't have these, no big deal. You can use pins. You can also just kind of hold these with your hands as well. I just sort of like to have the pin or the clips because it kind of keeps everything in place. Now I will put measurements for everything below in the description box, or I might even write it up in a PDF so you can download and print it. We'll see how ambitious I get. And you can really use this process for any size bag you want. You don't have to make it the size that we're making. You don't have to make your outside two-tone like what we're going to do today. You could use a charm pack or a mini charm and patchwork together something. Just as long as whatever you have for the outside of your bag is the same size as what you have for the inside of your bag. So for example, that once we get done sewing these pieces together, we're going to have a piece that measures 24.5 by 12.5, and so just make sure that whatever you kind of piece together, it's that size. And then the two inside pieces you're going to have are 12.5 by 12.5. Your strap is going to be 2.5 by I think this was 8, let me check really quick, 8 inches for that. And then some batting that is at least 12.5 inches wide by 24.5 inches long. I don't ever cut my batting to size. As you can see, I have some extra on the sides here, and I also cut it a little bit longer so that I'll have some overhang when I go to quilt these two pieces together. So I just kind of rough cut this just to make sure I have enough and call it good. All right, so, oh, you're also gonna need
either some scissors or a rotary trimmer and a ruler. You can kind of do either one. I like to use a rotary trimmer because I feel like I get a straighter line that way, but you certainly don't have to have one of these. You can just use regular fabric scissors as well. All right, so I think that is all the supplies we need. Oh, of course you'll need your sewing machine and some thread. So let's go ahead and get started. The first thing we're gonna do is piece together our outer lining. And this is essentially going to be the top of the bag, and then this will kind of wrap around to be the bottom of the bag. So you'll see what I mean for that in just a sec. So let's go ahead and go over to the sewing machine. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is just remove one of our top pieces here and just set that aside, and we're going to sew one of the top pieces to our bottom fabric. And all we're going to do is just make sure that they're obviously lined up, the 12 and a half inch side together, and then we're going to fold them together right sides together and sew along this edge at a quarter of an inch seam. Once I'm done doing that, I'm going to do the same thing to this side and just sew the other piece to that side, so that when we open it up we kind of have one solid piece with your accent fabrics on either side of your base bottom kind of unit of your bag. All right, so let's go over to the sewing machine and we'll sew both of those sides down and then we'll move on. Alright, so that is all done. We've sewn both of our pieces on here to the edges, and then I'm actually just going to take this over to my ironing board and just press my seams. It doesn't matter which way you press. You can press them open, you can press them to the darker side if you have a darker fabric. For this project, it's not really going to matter one way or the other, so just do whatever kind of suits your, whatever you prefer or whatever fits your fabric better. All right, the next thing that we're going to want to do is lay out our batting piece, and then with right sides together, with the wrong side of your fabric towards your batting, you're just gonna smooth out the piece that you made for the outside of your bag. All right, now, I forgot to mention in the instructions, if you would like, this is totally optional. I like to use the 505 temporary fabric adhesive. You can totally pin this to your batting if you prefer, either way. Or if you've used fusible batting, then you would just iron it. The side that has the bumps is the fusible side, and the side that's smooth is the non-fusible side. So you would actually just take this piece and go over and iron it down, and then you don't even have to do any of the quilting that I'm gonna do. I just like to do some quilting on my bags because I think it's fun. But if you don't like to do quilting, you can totally skip this part. If you don't want to do quilting, I suggest you use the fusible batting. That way you just fuse it to the outside of your fabric, and then you don't have to quilt it. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead, since I just have regular batting, I'm gonna go ahead and kind of peel up this side. And all I do, I usually do this in kind of a well-ventilated area. And then I'm just gonna give it a little bit of a spray and then lay that back down so it's nice and not going anywhere. And then I actually do the same thing to the other side. Just flick this up. You don't even really have to put a lot on here because since this is such a small piece, you're not going to have a whole lot of movement. It can shift a little bit. If you don't want to do the 505 spray just because you don't like it, you can also simply pin it to the batting like you normally would if you were to do a quilted project. So now we're going to take this over to the machine, and you can have as much fun as you want with this part. I think I'm going to probably do maybe some diagonal straight lines on this bottom section just to give it a little bit more stability. Maybe some horizontal lines across the top. You can also just run like a seam, you know, down or a line out down the side of your seams. You can do free motion swirling, or you can totally skip this step altogether. So we're just gonna go over and have a little bit of fun with our machine now and just get this kind of quilted up and attached to the batting piece. And then I will meet you back over here for adding the zippers. Okay. So I'm just gonna do some basic straight line quilting. I didn't even change the foot on my machine. I just have my quarter inch foot. You're really only having batting in. I also have a tutorial on straight line and free motion quilting on my YouTube channel. So if you don't know how to do this, then you can go ahead and go check that out. I'm going to speed it up and probably just put some music over it because my machine is really loud. But I'm just gonna go ahead and do this and then I'll show you what we're gonna do next. All right, so now that I have my quilting done, I'm gonna go ahead and trim it down to size. So now you can kind of probably see why I just left some outside batting because it just doesn't really matter that much. And also sometimes when you are quilting a project, it can kind of push things and your fabric can get a little, your outside edge can get a little wonky. So now is just a good time to straighten all that up and take care of any pieces that got a little crazy on you. And just get this down to a good size. And I'm just going to cut it so that it's basically, I'm not measuring it really right now, but I am, it should still be 15.5 by 24.5. Once we're done here, we'll just check it. And this ruler is actually 24.5. So it looks like I'm pretty close. All right, and there we go. Okay, so here is our outside of our bag piece. And then now we are going to prepare our little handle. So we can kind of set this aside. Now you can do this one of two ways. I don't like to have to flip inside out you know, things that are this skinny. It's just like my least favorite thing to do. If you don't mind that, just fold this right sides together and just sew a quarter of an inch seam along these and then use, you know, one of your little pin tools or whatever and flip it out right side out. What I'm actually going to do is just press a quarter of an inch seam here. Well, actually what I do is I press it in half and then just press a quarter of an inch seam in on both sides. And then I take it to my machine and just top stitch down the open edge and then the other edge just to kind of give it a finished look. So I'll kind of show you what that looks like. Okay, so I have taken this over to my ironing board and I just pressed it in half. As you can see, hopefully there's a seam right there. And then I also just pressed in about a quarter of an inch down both sides. And now I'm actually just going to take this over to my sewing machine. I give it a nice, good, solid press so it's not going to go anywhere. And then I just run a top stitch down this side. If you want to make this strap wider, you can totally do that. Not a big deal what size this is. It's eventually going to get put in half like that, so your strap will kind of look like this. So just make it whatever size you want. I do have the dimensions for it, you know, in the project below. And if you prefer to stitch it and flip it inside out, be my guest. I just really hate doing that, especially when it's really skinny like this. And I find that this method actually works just as good, and then I don't have to turn anything inside out. So I'm gonna take this over to the sewing machine now, and we're just gonna run our stitches. So here's our strip, and we're just going to set this aside for right now. The next thing that we're going to work on is attaching our zipper. Now, zippers are actually really easy. Like I mentioned, you just want to make sure that your zipper is longer than whatever size width you just decided to make your bag, okay? And ours is, so we're good to go. So the first thing that we're going to do is attach it to one of the sides of our outside of our edge of our bag. So this is the outside. It's right side up. So we're going to leave it like that. Then you're going to take your zipper, and if you can see here, here's our zipper pull. Okay, we're going to put, that's basically what's called the right side of the zipper. We're going to put that down toward the bag lining. All right, so here's a little bit closer view. Here's the top of our bag, so pretty side up. And then you're going to take your zipper and put it right side down. And right now it doesn't matter where the zipper head is. It will in just a little bit, but right now it doesn't. You actually kind of just want it out of the way. And then just line up the edge of your zipper with the edge of your bag and just make sure that that's all good. And then you're going to take a piece of your lining fabric and place that right side down. So the right side of your lining is going to be touching the right side of your bag. And you're going to line that up as well with the zipper. And then you're just going to take some of these clips and just put a few down the edge just to keep everything in place. You can also use pins. You can also just carry it over to the machine and kind of line it up as you go. But essentially what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this over to the machine, and as close as we can to our zipper without sewing into the teeth here, we're going to do a line all the way down this edge. And okay, so I'm just gonna make sure that everything is lined up along this edge, and I can kind of pull these clips out as I go. And I'm just running my presser foot really alongside of the zipper. I'm not even using a zipper foot. So if you have one, you can totally use one and you'll get a little bit closer. I'm fine with it looking like this, so you don't have to run out and buy a specialty foot. Okay. And then if you open it up, you should essentially have your bag with the right side of the zipper, and then the lining will be on this side. All right, now I am going to take this over to my ironing board, and I'm just going to press this back, and then I'm also going to press this side back right here, and then I'll just run a quick top stitch down this edge just to secure these two pieces so they stay together. Okay, so I've just taken my iron and just pressed this edge over, and then I've also pressed back this edge, and I'm just gonna run a quick top stitch all the way down just to kind of secure the pieces, and then also it kind of makes it look a little bit more finished as well. And there we go. And when you're doing this step, you might also want to just go a little bit slowly because you're going to be going through quite a few layers of fabric, and so your machine might just need you to slow down just a little bit. All right, so let's go back over to the cutting board and I'll show you how to add the other side to this. All right, so we're back over at our cutting board, and here is the zipper that we just added with the top stitch. Now we're going to actually sew the other side of the bag to the zipper to finish it off. So what we're going to do, this can get a little bit tricky, so just keep in mind that we're actually doing the exact same thing we did on this side. So we're going to take our outside edge of our bag and have that facing up. We're going to take our zipper with the right side and place that going down. Okay, and then we're going to take our other piece of lining And we're going to put that right sides down along that edge and clip everything together. So again, that's the front of your bag outside, the right side of your zipper. Okay, so you've got your bag touching your bag. And then we're going to add the lining, so you'll have lining touching lining. Hopefully that makes sense. Okay, and then we're just going to pin this really quickly and go over to the machine. We're going to do the exact same thing. We're just going to stitch as close to that zipper as we can get down this edge. And then I'm going to press it open and then run a top stitch down it as well. All right, so let's go do that. Okay, so here we are. Your bag should be kind of looking like this. I did take it over and just press this. This is the second seam that we sewed open. So you kind of have the two inside flaps, and then you've also got this kind of curve, which is the outside of your bag. So now just to run the top stitch down this like we did before, I actually like to just take my bag at this point and just unzip this. Make sure you have one of those stoppers on here so you don't unzip it all the way. And then that makes it a little bit easier to get this into my sewing machine to run a top stitch down that edge. So I'm going to go ahead and do that really quick, and then we'll be back here and I'll show you how to sew the rest of the bag together. Okay, so I've got my top stitches down both sides of my zipper here, and now this next step is very important, or you're going to have a very difficult time turning your bag inside out. So what I'm going to do is unzip my zipper, probably about that far, more than halfway, but you do need to leave some on this side because we're actually going to be stitching around our bag now. So what you're going to do is take your outside flaps and put them together, and then take your bag section and fold it together so that you kind of have this longer piece now, where you've got your lining next to your lining and your bag side next to your bag. And you want to, especially if you have done a two-tone bag like I have, what's going to matter is that these two seams right here line up. So that's the first thing that I'll do with this, just to line these up, is I'll just make sure that those line up like so, and then I'll put a clip in it. So that's my first clip. And then I'm going to do the same thing on the other side, just make sure that my colors line up, and put a clip there. Just because this is something that you're going to see on the outside of the bag where they line up, and you're going to want them to look kind of nice and neat and organized. The other thing that I do then is kind of fold my zipper in half a little bit, and you're going to want it folded in half with along the right side, I guess you could say. And essentially what we're going to do is sew all the way around, except for on this side of this is your bag lining. You're going to want to leave a spot about, I don't know, 4 or 5 inches wide enough to get your bag through. It depends on how big of a bag you're making, but we're basically going to sew from here all down this side, and then down this side over to here, and just leave a hole so that you can turn your bag inside out. So I'm going to go ahead and just kind of pin this, get everything lined up, pin it together. So before we sew our bag together, I want to show you where to add your little tab here. Now all you're going to do is take it and fold it in half, and then if you have like one side that looks better than the other, you just put that on the outside. Fold it in half, and then with the rough edges are going to go against the rough edges of the bag here, and so you want it on the opposite side of where the zipper pull is. So my zipper pull starts here and opens this way, so I'm going to put my tag on, my little handle on that side of the bag. So I'm just going to push it in there, and you can decide how wide you want it. Like I can feel right now, or how long you want it. It stops right here. I actually want my little tag for this bag to be about this long. If you want it shorter, just pull it farther towards the end. You can always cut this off, so you can kind of adjust it to wherever you want. I do want it all the way in, so I am going to line it up there, as you can see. So I've got my right sides of my bag here, and then my
little pull right there. And I have it down about, I don't know, an inch or so from the zipper. And then just line all that up. You can add an extra little clip there so that when you're stitching around your bag, you'll catch your little handle in there. So let's go do that. Now when you get to the corner, all you have to do is leave your needle in the down position, lift it up, turn it to the side, and keep going. And I did a back stitch here as well. And now we're gonna do the same thing down the other side. Okay, so as you can see, I have left an opening here for us to turn our bag, but before we can do that, we're going to square off these corners, so I will show you how to do that. All right, so I'm gonna show you how to square off the corners of the bottom of your bag, and so we're gonna need to do this to all four corners. So we're gonna start with one of the lining corners, and all you need to do is kind of stick your hand in here, and I just put my finger in one of these corners here, and then I clamp down on it this way. Okay, so the corner was this way to begin with, and now it's going to get clamped this way. And then I just feel the seams and just make sure that the seams are lined up with each other, okay? And then now the next thing I'm going to do is just take my ruler and measure in 2 inches. Now you can totally make your bag a different size. It's completely up to you. We're going to do 2 inches, but if you want it to be a wider bottom, you could do 3 inches. If you don't want it to be this wide, you could do like 1.5 or 1 inch. And so all you're doing is taking your little point here that we've created. Make sure you can turn my bag so you can see this. Just take your little point here that you've created. Make sure that the seams are lined up and you can feel with your finger that they are. And then put the point where your stitches meet at, 2 inches. And here's my 2-inch marker right there. And it's probably hard to see on camera, but I'm lining this 2-inch line up with my stitch line here. And then you can kind of see that my diagonal line is going along the edge of my corner. And it's coming, it's touching this point right here at the 2-inch mark right here. All right, so just try and get as straight as you can across there. This will pretty much guarantee that you've got a straight line going across, but line up your 2-inch line on this, and then the 2-inch point right here, and then just with a pin, or this is just one of those erasable, friction erasable markers that will come off. It won't matter, you won't see this. This is on the inside of the bag. I just make a line, and then I would probably either use my clips or just throw a pin in here just to make sure that it doesn't move around on you. And then we're gonna take this machine and sew right along this line, and then we'll trim it off, leaving ourselves about 1/4 of an inch excess hangover. And we're gonna do that to all four corners. All right, so we've done this corner. We're gonna come over. Again, just stick our finger in there and pinch it together. Line up the seams as best as we can. That's pretty lined up to me. You don't want any, just make sure you don't have any folds on this side or on this side. You want everything nice and smooth and flat, and the seams are lined up. Again, I'm gonna line up my 2-inch marker with my stitch line here, which I'm sure you probably can't see, and the point of my point here, and then this diagonal. And that should give us a pretty straight line. Scoot that down a little bit. Doesn't have to be, you want it to be close, but if you are off just a tad bit, it's not a big deal. And as you can see, I kind of messed up my line there. All right, and then just pin it. Going to do that same process to the outside corners of your bag as well. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and just trim off these edges. If you aren't totally sure, you know, how wide you want your bag, you can always do one corner and then flip it right side out and just look at it before you cut it off, because once we cut it off here, you know, we're kinda, that's the size it is, so. But I'm just gonna go ahead and cut that edge off, and then I'll do all four corners that way. Sorry, I'm gonna turn it this way so I don't cut myself. And this doesn't have to be exactly a quarter of an inch, just a quarter of an inch is fine. Eyeball it. Nobody's gonna see it, it's gonna be inside. Okay, all right, so we are almost done now. Okay, so we're almost done. We've squared off all of our edges. We still have this opening here. And we do have these little zipper flaps kind of still hanging out. So all we need to do at this point is go ahead and just trim those off. And don't have to be scared because that's all included in your sewing now. And then we can just reach in and turn our bag right side out and just be careful. I did backstitch when I was leaving that hole in my lining here, just so that I don't rip it apart when I pull it through here. But here we've got our bag kind of puffing out. And there's our little handle. And you just kind of want to push everything out, just make sure everything looks okie dokie, okay, which it does. You can kind of unzip it a little bit more now just to get to our lining piece. And then the last step that we have is to just sew our lining bottom edge together here. And you can use an iron if you like. A lot of times what I'll do is just kind of finger press it like this. Take it over to my sewing machine and then just run a quick stitch around that. And then we just tuck it inside our bag and we're all done. I do a back stitch at the front and end of this as well. Okay guys, so that's all sealed up, and now all we have to do is just tuck this inside of our bag. Just kind of pop out those corners a little bit. Like yay. Pop that out, and then voila, we're good. And we've got our little handle here, and we've got our fun lining inside. Cute bag on the outside. This is great for knitting projects. I plan to put my new socks that I just started in here. One thing that's great about this for knitting projects is, since this is nice and flexible, you can just take this bag and turn it this way. You can have your yarn and whatnot inside of here, and you don't even have to take your yarn out of the bag. You can just knit with your yarn coming out of the bag as you go, and then when you're done, you can just put your work back in it, close it up, zip it up, and be on your way. So there you have it. If you are curious, my finished bag is approximately 11 inches wide by about 9 3/4 inches tall. I think this is actually a perfect size for my knit projects. You can also put, like, you could fit an iPad in here, you know, books, school supplies, really kind of anything you want, you can certainly use this bag for. So,
all right, everyone, so thank you so much for watching. Here's my completed bag, and it's got its goodies inside it. So anyways, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Hopefully it was easy and inspired you guys to make some of your own bags. Now, like I mentioned before, I have dubbed this the squishy bag, and so if you make any projects with this, please make sure to tag me so that I can see what you've made. I'd love to see what color combos you come up with and maybe what you use your bags for. I am tagging it the squishy bag on my Instagram. So if you tag it with that, I'll try and kind of keep an eye of the projects that are showing up with that tag. And we can all kind of share our own ideas and maybe glean inspiration from each other. So I hope you enjoyed this bag tutorial. Hopefully it was easy for you to follow along. If you have any questions, I'll make sure to put all of my information below. I'll also have all the measurements below for all of this as well, like I mentioned. And hopefully you enjoy this project. Thank you so much for spending some time with me today, and I will see you next time.